Hey folks, Jesse Randall, Michigan State University Forestry Innovation Center, outside of Escanaba at our hide facility. What we are doing today and what we want to highlight today is something very new for this station. Historically, we have grown trees and our whole focus at the station has been about growing trees as fast as possible. So our rotation length as short as possible for the biggest possible tree. And the thought always has been that we could have that enter a wood waste heating stream. And so today now, that whole mindset is coming to fruition with this this hoop structure and the drying structure. We are pleased to announce that we are going to be getting a wood chip boiler. And so the wood chip boiler does not have to have really good clean chips like you would see entering the pulp and paper stream. So we can get away with a little bit of bark or more bark and some branches. But most trees, when you cut them down and chip them up, it's gonna give you a moisture reading somewhere around 50-51% moisture. So there's a lot of heat that gets tied up when you're converting that wet wood chip into a combustible material. The first thing you have to do is dry it out in that combustion chamber, and that takes heat away from what your primary goal is, which is heating a building. So we built this facility as a learning experience, as a prototype, as a demonstration unit, and to get some research out of it. And what you're looking at is Mitch and I came in. We had to take some conifer trees down for another building project that's gonna be happening here on the station. We've turned these chips into now usable fuel. And partly the danger when we do that, when we put them into a big mound, is within the first 12 to 24 hours, the chips being 50% moisture, there's sugar there. They are now in a very confined space because they've been all layered on top of each other. Microbes can begin to work, and those microbes generate heat, and that heat can get to the point where it will actually start the pile on fire. And that's a really big concern, even over at the paper mill here in Escanaba. The chips don't ever stay in that pile for very long because the last thing they want is a raging chip fire over there at a paper mill. Same thing, I don't wanna have to look out here and see smoke rising off this pile as this building burns down. So what we need to do is somehow force air through those chips to dry them. We're using the natural air on these hot, dry days. We're forcing the air through a series of piping systems. Now the first one we tried is a 15-inch black pipe that you'd see under a road. And we drilled holes into it. We put a very large fan on the backside of it. And I'm gonna take you around in a few minutes and show you the fan that we use. And we got to thinking, you know, that pipe only gets a certain amount of surface area exposed to that high pressure air that we're blowing through it. So Mitch and I put our heads together and we thought, well, why don't we use some sewer pipe? It's meant to be buried in the ground, so we know it can handle the weight. It's already perforated. And so we added a few more rows of perforations to the pipe. But what we did is we came in on the backside of this where the pipe from the fan comes in, and we teed off of a main, what I call my main trunk line, my main 15-inch air moving line. And then every foot we've added a 3.5 to 3 inch septic line. And so Antonio, if you shoot down here, these are the very ends of the lines. These lines are 20 feet long. They're perforated the entire length. And so now what we've done is we've taken that fan, and that fan can blow about 3,000 cubic feet per minute through this system. And now these 13 or 14 runs spaced evenly across the floor with their air holes blowing up are forcing air through this chip pile. Now, when the chips are drying, what's interesting is the center of this pile is drying faster than the top and the very sides, all right? Because that dry air is picking up moisture from those lower chips and forcing it up and out. These fans are designed to move air through very large piles of field corn, all right? They are radial axial fans, and so they can take a lot of static back pressure. And surprisingly, when you look at wood chips have more air flow through them than the pile of corn. And so we really are not dealing with a lot of back pressure on this fan. And so what we've done, I've also went and I got a thermometer that it's got a long probe on it. This is meant originally for hay. It's meant to go into a hay bale to see if it's gonna light on fire. And so what you do is you put that in here, and I'm in about a foot because I want to see that it is at most ambient temperature. And what I would actually expect is as the air is picking up moisture, we all know that moist air as it's evaporating is cooler. It's giving off the heat and it's actually chilling. And so our air temperature right now is in the upper 70s, low 80s here in Escanaba. Right now, the air is picking that moisture up and evaporating it off the chips out of the pile. You can see my temperature is around 67.9. So this chip pile is about 10 degrees cooler than the outside air temperature right now. And that's because we're evaporating that water and it's doing exactly what we want. Now this other meter that I have, this is a moisture meter. What it's doing is it's sending an electrical pulse down through the tips and back up, and it's measuring the length of time it takes for this dual probe to send that electric pulse. And it knows the resistance of water and how water transmit electricity. And so it's internally calibrated for moisture. And so when we turn it on, and what I'm doing is I'm just putting it in horizontal to it. It takes a few minutes for it to balance out, because while you're putting it in there, it's measuring friction. There might hit a piece of bark. And so again, that chip pile started at about 50%, give or take, moisture. Right now we're reading this chip pile and it's still balancing itself out around 35.5%. And this air blower, we had moved it over onto this new platform yesterday. It was in the low 40s as an average. And so you can see we're losing anywhere from 5 to 10% moisture in this chip pile in about 24 to 36 hours of runtime of forcing that air through it. Now, when you look at some of the literature coming out of Europe, they do a lot of this forced air drying, and they will actually put hot air heat exchangers so the air is actually heated that blows through these chips. We're going to do that when our boiler is in place and we have extra heat that we don't need to run the entire facility here. But our goal is by early winter, if all goes well, we will have a fully functioning chip boiler that will heat the sugar house that we're going to build. It'll heat our graduate student lodge. It'll heat our office and shop complex and the residents here at the station. So it really is going to be a universal heating system run off of wood chips that we produce on a weekly or monthly basis. We're constantly working in our plantations. We're removing dead and dying trees from our landscape. And as emerald ash borer now is coming through the Upper Peninsula, our woods is not immune. And so our ash trees in certain portions of the station are beginning to die from EAB. And so those things that can't make logs, we're gonna turn them into a usable chip. We're gonna put them in this drying facility. We're gonna dry them down. And then we're gonna heat our facility with things that normally wouldn't have an open market because the overall chip market in the Upper Peninsula and across really the northern reaches really has taken a hit because of the price of natural gas. Natural gas being so cheap, it's no longer economical to produce chips to use at the mill for their hog boiler, their fuel boiler, to provide heat and steam at the plant. So with this is a prototype. We're taking some technology from the corn and the ag sectors, and we're putting it to use here for forestry. So these are those small radial axial fans that we've purchased and are using. This one moves about 3,000 cubic feet a minute, and it's designed and it's built for that static back pressure. You know, there's resistance when you push air into there. But I just wanted to show you that we've poured a pad of concrete, and we're gonna be able to move this fan backwards so we can put an air exchanger in there. And I wanted to draw your attention, when we poured the concrete, and I know we have video of this, and you've seen this if you followed our videos, but we've laid down PEX tubing, and this PEX runs in the concrete because we're actually gonna bleed off heat, and you know, in the spring and in the fall, when winter really isn't calling for really cold temperatures and the facilities here don't need to be heated with the full capacity of our boiler. We're gonna pull off heat, and we're gonna heat the concrete. We're also going to have some valving out here such that in those times where we have extra heat, we're gonna be able to turn a valve, and we're gonna be able to put heat into a heat exchanger right in here that's separating, it'll be in between our air blower and this central, what I call my trunk line, where the air is delivered into the chips. And so we're gonna be able to blow ambient air if it's dry, or we're gonna blow warm, hot air in the wintertime to really facilitate drying. One of the things you have to understand with wood chips, they're 50% moisture, as we talked about earlier. They will freeze solid if you're not careful. So if we take a tree, we chip it, we throw it in this chip house, and we walk away and we don't do any drying, what'll happen is it'll freeze into a solid block of wood, which is also not what we want when we want those chips to be fed into that boiler. So I just want to show you what this fan sounds like, because that also is a very important consideration when you're siting this location. So we've sited this building such that the back end of it, where we've hidden the fans, it's away from the lodge, it's away from the office, it's away from the residence, so we don't have to hear these fans blowing. Now, they're not gonna blow 24/7, 365. These fans are only gonna blow for probably 2, 3, maybe 4 days if our weather conditions are not right. And then what we'll do is we'll also put thermal resistors in there. And so we'll be measuring what the temperature is. We'll be measuring what the moisture content is. If for some reason we start to see that temperature rise and those fans aren't on, we'll know with an alarm to come out, turn the fans on, and blow off any excess heat. So it will be part of our safety operation when we're dealing with green chips, is to have the proper monitoring in place. So we'll show you that as we go to install those. Now, for the time being, these fans are so small that they come with just a regular 110 plug-in. And we are gonna hardwire these into a switch and into hard power, but time was of the essence. We needed to get the trees down and save the chips. So we ran a very heavy extension cord from the outlet to these guys. And so you'll hear these things start up, and they are quite loud when they do. So I'll stop talking. I'll let Antonio just shoot this, and then we'll be done for the day. But follow us, like us on Facebook, follow us on Facebook and on Twitter. And find us on YouTube under Uper Forestry. We're gonna have all of our videos, all of our educational content goes on those platforms. So when in doubt, send us a comment, give us ideas of what else you'd like to see. With that, be safe. 2020 is a year to remember.